I have a friend who has a house in the middle of nowhere. I'm not joking, it took us 8 hours on the train to get here. We arrived late yesterday evening, so there wasn't much to see outside, but opening my blinds this morning, I was perplexed by the beauty around me, and suddenly it made sense that this desolate place was so far from the city I lived in. Here, there was enough space for sheep and cow to graze. I could already imagine myself setting up a little farm with a set of aggressive geese who hate me and a goat who I would feed and then milk to make goat's cheese from on the weekends. I would have 4 chickens to make my very own egg and cress sandwiches. I would have a pig walking around my house called Ben and a slightly overweight rat perched on my left shoulder called Gaston for company. In the afternoon we went for a walk around the local town, a strip of no more than 15 houses aligned along the road with a solitary local produce shop here and there. I loved the place and I could feel the simplicity and plainness seeping into my veins. It was like someone had sprayed pesticide onto my brain, getting rid of the thought parasites that had nestled into the crests and grooves of my fragile mind. I imagined what my farm life with Ben and Gaston would look like, what philosophies I would radically and religiously adapt, what color I would paint my kitchen. At night, I dreamed of my Scottish fantasy, and the initial figments of my imagination had now clumped together, forming a breathing version of me that was living in the Highlands. That night's restful sleep had further expanded my vision. It was the year 1991. I had become abstinent of eating meat, leaving Gaston with enough goat's cheese to live on for the rest of his long red life. I had started writing a novel that described nothing but how I drank my coffee every morning in extreme, intricate detail. The only thing I wore all day was a long green dress and massive boots so I could walk through shit all day with Ben and not care. My farm didn't have electricity, but Gaston would run around on his wheel at 6 o'clock every night for an hour, partly to supply us with electricity so I could watch some TV, partly to ensure his BMI would not reach dangerous levels. I had magically mastered the art of sourdough making, and prior to baking I would stick my fingers into the soft dough to make space for the olives that would roast alongside it. I could see me, Gaston and Ben pose for our annual family picture and celebrating my birthday with a dry slap of centrifuged nuts and used coffee grounds. It looked like a great life.
Hello. I just woke up from the fattest nap of my life because it's the 21st of December. Oh no, 21st, 31st of December. And it's New Year's tonight.
With dribble still stuck to my face, I was violently awakened from my lucid light dream and quickly realized I wasn't a secluded hippie wearing a rotten potato sack as a dress and talking to a crumbled up heap of old newspapers that I thought was a talking rat I had adopted on my visit to Paris the year before. I was a 21-year-old thriving female who was meant to have her face smothered in makeup by now to then sip on elaborately labeled wine, simultaneously agreeing on the fact that AI was going to take over the world and that we were all doomed. And so we moved on to some cocktails.
S'en va, tout se meurt, tu ne crois plus à notre bonheur, et tu deviens sans raison ni cause, nerveuse et morose, rose, 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 ah oui, je me souviens, j'avais quoi, 17 ans, toi, peut-être un peu moins, quand tu séchais tes cours et venais le matin pour m'apporter ton cœur comme un bouton de rose. Rose, rose, amour de mon passé, quand tu venais me voir dans ma chambre au grenier, je trouvais que ta peau sentait le foin mouillé. Et quand je t'embrassais, mais ça c'est autre chose. Tout s'en va, tout se meurt, tu veux fermer ta porte à mon cœur. J'entends déjà le vent qui se lève pour chasser mes rêves. Eve,
guys, you're gonna love this material.
Eve, 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 encore un souvenir qui m'a brûlé le cœur avant que de faiblir. J'ai cru devenir fou, j'ai voulu en mourir, mais le temps guérit tout un jour sans pied. Eve, Eve, à mordre follement dans le fruit de l'amour, on se brise les dents. Si tu m'as fait du mal,
hey guys, as you can tell, it's actually the new year now. Oh, I've got the hiccups. We had a really good night. It was really fun. I think it's always the best thing to celebrate a new year in a completely different town, because then you get like the locals and everyone's like, it's a community, you know. I hope you're gonna have a fantastic new year. And now I'm gonna sleep because I'm tired.
Station, and we're on our way back to London, and this is the end of the video, unfortunately. And now we have a 9-hour journey back to London. It's fucking long as fuck. I literally can't believe that we're having travel so far, because when I go to Holland, I'm Netherlands, it is about 4 hours, and that's a different country. And we had a great time in general. It was very bonding, female bonding time, because it was only girls, and you know, girls doing girl shit. bye guys. Thank you so much for watching my video and I'll see you very soon. Wave!